Sexy people of the interwebs. Ooh. We got a situation. Uh-oh. Yeah, you're number one, Scott. They're smooth. What's really going on? Let this truck move out the way, Jonathan. Yeah, that's a sister company right there. Total. Yeah, he's parked in the middle, literally, of the driveway. Let's update everybody if I can ever get this thing spun around. Hang on. Sorry about y'all shaking there. That's me. I did that. All right. Okay. Apparently, he was going to back into one of these places where I'm parked, and his airline broke. And he drugged the trailer because he was kind of blocking this area. So he drugged the trailer over there. It's wet and nasty right now anyway, so it doesn't really matter. He drugged the trailer over a little bit so he could get out of everybody's way. He needs a whole new airline. It's those black ones, like rubber-like, like what I got on here. Not like those cheap-ass plastic slinky-looking damn things, the blue ones and the red ones. No, this, yeah. I feel so bad for him, man. I do. Anyway, to answer your question, did I find a trailer? Yes, I found one. It's already hooked to my truck. Nobody got back with me from last night. Nobody said anything. And you know, I got this eternal fear that I was gonna need California skirts on the trailer. And I was gonna get denied or get shut down or some shit like that, because you know, California can be that way. So, what had happened was, the new gal this morning that I'm talking to, there's Eddie from LA, man. The new gal that I'm talking to this morning, fleet manager and everything like that. She didn't know either, but she asked somebody there, that one of the other fleet managers that runs teams, and the team lady told her, don't worry about it. They run in and out of there with the trailers anyway. If they weren't manufactured with the skirt, then it didn't need it. Okay, that's not accurate. Hey, Cheyenne, how you doing? Okay. So, I had to look it up my damn self. And apparently, 2009, December 31st of 2009 is when this came into effect. That California, their CARB requirements, C-A-R-B, CARB requirements state that trailers manufactured after that date had to have the skirts. And it goes into quite a bit of detail about the skirts and the wings too on the back. But seeing how this one was manufactured like 2004, it's exempt from that law. So yeah, trailer's got to wear a skirt if it's manufactured after December 31st 2009. If it's a brand new 2010, came off the line, well, that would be probably a 2011 if it was manufactured in 2010. But anyway, I digress. They're like, no, just go ahead and roll with that trailer. And I'm like, okay. Well, I need four tires. So that's why I'm here at the Loves in Baxter, Tennessee. I need four tires. But they don't know if I need four tires because they haven't got the photographs of me. I'm not gonna get in there for hours. There's like three trucks getting tires before me. So it's gonna be a while. So I'm having Twinkies. You know, I miss these so bad. I haven't had them on the truck in so long. And the last time I had them on the truck, I had a little bit of money. Now that I don't have any money, I don't get these. I miss these. Called Tennessee Pride. Sausage and I think they're buttermilk biscuits. This is my every morning, man. This is my breakfast. I've been getting tired of them damn Pop-Tarts, you know what I mean? I gotta have something I can eat on the run. Cause you know I'm a mover and a shaker and a big money maker. So we're gonna be here a while. We're only about 18 miles from my pickup tomorrow. And I got all night. So it's all good. Hey, Randy, how you doing? Hey, Pro, how you doing? All right. So let's go back and start the reading process here. See what I missed. Lickety thought that was stupid parking. Nah, he just didn't have a choice. The trailer parked him. The truck and trailer parked him. Mm-hmm. Hey, Mikhail, you doing? I ain't far from you right now, Dylan. Aren't you down there in, like, Chattanooga? Eddie from L.A. Bobtail to ATL, man. That's cool, Jonathan. I don't like bobtailing in bad weather. I hope it's good weather where you're bobtailing, buddy. Pros in the house. I have been fine and dandy, Randy. I just made a rhyme. I'm a poet and didn't know it. Finished school Friday, just waiting to go test. Get it on, Randy. Get it on. You know, the funny part about the Texas test, I remember talking to somebody about this here. There's parts of the test that you don't even have to take and you can still pass. Like, you got a backing in a straight line test, and then they want you to parallel park the truck, offset backing. And you don't even have to do the offset backing. It's only like, you know, a few points off. No big deal. You don't even have to do it. But if you do it and you hit the curb, you fail. So why do it? Unless you're looking for 100. If you're one of those that's looking for 100 on everything, well, you're going to have to do it. Smithville. I don't even know where that is. But now you got me looking. Dun 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 dun. I know. You're right, it is only about 15 minutes. Where the hell is this here? Liberty. Liberty. this is Sparta. Okay, so Smithville is before you go over the bridges over that little, what you call it right there. Wait a minute. Okay. Yeah, that's where 56 goes in. Shit, I can't find a damn thing. Okay, there we go. That's where I think it is. Okay. So this is where I'm at. Nope. Dumbass. You're not. Where the hell am I? Oh, I'm way the fuck up here. Okay, now I'm putting Smithville in perspective. Okay, see, I've been to Smithville. Center Hill Lake. I spent a week on Center Hill Lake with a buddy of mine. He lives right around here. As a matter of fact, over in Cookeville. He took me to Center Point Lake. One of the best times I ever had in my life, to be quite honest. I really loved it, man. But we had to go through Smithville. Well, as a matter of fact, we went to Smithville, to the Wally World, I think, to get tents. Because we pitched tents. Yeah, we did the whole pitching the tent and, you know, the camping out at the lake kind of thing. Yeah, we got all kinds of shit, food and all kinds of shit right there, man. That was a good week. That was a very good week. I like Smithville. Smithville rocks. Cool. Luke. All right, y'all got to hang on just a second. Stand by, all units, stand by. How you doing? What you got going on? What do you mean you can't find one? Thought you sent me a... No, don't be an asshole. I thought you found a second one. Yeah. And you're gonna find a lot of the RVs have water damage. They have leakies. That's a. Yeah. I got you. I'm down with that. Yeah. So you got a rotten ceiling, and he smoked in it for 8 years. Possibly not a good purchase. Now, me personally, I could take that thing and I could clean it up on the inside enough and, go over the walls with kills and paint it and stuff like that. After cleaning the nicotine off the walls, I could probably get that thing where you could handle the smoky thing, but you'd have to take out any kind of furniture that has any kind of fabric to it. But the ceiling, that's a total rebuild, especially if it's anywhere near the air conditioner, where the air conditioner sits on top. Oh, good. Hang on just a second. Hey, Luke, welcome to the room, man. Welcome to the room. Come back. Hit that bell so you know whenever we come back in that you're in here. Okay, Jonathan, that's pretty cool. 0400, 4 in the morning. Oh, yeah, no, I know where it's at, Dylan. I know where it's at. You're going to end up trying to buy a FEMA trailer. I see that coming. Well, I'll tell you where I seen them. There's an RV dealer in Bastrop. I think it's on like 22 or something. Yeah, he's right there on the highway, and he had a whole mess of them. And he might not be advertising or some shit like that, but you could look into that. How about that? No, I didn't say drive. No. You Google it, baby. You Google it. I'm loving you. I love you. Me rub you. I rub you a long time. I know you're frustrated, sweetheart. I get it. Well, don't be afraid. You will. Look at Bastrop real quick, okay? And call me back, okay? Please. My daughter is like at third level, can't talk to her kind of thing going on right now. No, the school doesn't even know when I'm going. They claim DMV is booked up until the 28th. That sucks. Oh yeah, and that's a thing, Randy. That's a thing. That's a very, very bad thing. A lot of times, you'll have to find a rural, if you're you know, trying to take the law into your own hands, so to speak. You'll have to find a rural place that does the testing that has less people lined up. The larger cities, man, they're backed up with people trying to take the test right there, man. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Dylan, you're right. Center Hill is the fucking bomb. People cheating on their significant other. Morally is not the right thing to do. That's a good blanket answer. I don't have any specifics to what you're talking about, so. But yeah. Smithfield makes good meat, ham, bacon, etc. Ooh, yes they do. Yes they do. You gotta rebuild. Yeah, you have to tear all of that shit down, and every piece of wood that's fuckered up, including the wood that goes down the sides, man. Yeah, but we've rebuilt those things. We rebuilt those, some of them in really bad shape. It's actually kind of fun in a way. Because when you get through, you got this, you know, finished product that doesn't look as good as it did coming off the line, but it can be better. You can make the RV better than it was before. Like Bionic RV. Jonathan thinks they're a piece of shit. Mark Years. What's up, people? How's everyone? I think everyone is doing it. Yeah, that's my daughter on the phone there, Liggety. Yeah, she's just, because she done made all these plans to move out, got that RV stuff, I shared it with y'all, and she went and looked at the first RV, it was a piece, so she found another one, found out that these people lie on Craigslist and all this shit, they lie. You get there to look at it, and then it's in far worse shape, so number two is out. See, if she would settle on a FEMA trailer, at least temporarily, she can get in. She can find those. They're everywhere, man. People have tried to do a whole lot of things with them. And when the oil boom happened, a shitload of them went out to West Texas, South Texas, East Texas, Louisiana. Fuckload of them went up to North Dakota. You know, that kind of thing. Maybe Pennsylvania, Ohio might have got their share of them too. But they're still around. I see them all over the place. I see them for sale all over the place. About $3,000 or less, man. You can grab one of those. And they were designed to live in, not to recreate in, not to pull around to RV stops. But they have larger refrigerators, sinks, toilets, bathrooms, etc. They were specifically designed to last a little longer than your normal RV as well. I drove over the road. I'm going 1 month at a time. Found out my woman had been cheating on me for over a year. Fuck me. Well, I'll tell you something about cheating women. They do it one time, they'll do it again. Even if they never do again, you still have to believe that they'll do it again. Just FYI. Every time you leave, it's going to fuck with your head. Big time. It's going to fuck with your head. What is she doing? You're not going to be concentrating on the road. It's not a safe environment. You got to cut ties. You know, what do they say? You got to cut bait or fucking get away from the pond. Is that how it goes? Fish or cut bait. That's how it goes. You got to fish or cut bait. But that doesn't really sound good with what we're talking about. I would just say, you just got to cut that fucking shit off and move on. My first ex-wife was like that, man. She was terrible. And I wasn't driving a truck at the time. She was just terrible. She was good, though. She was sneaky as fuck. It was kind of a challenge to catch her. Karma. Yep. The karma bus will swing around and knock you on your ass. Alright, so it's easy to get the CDL up in New York, Smooth says. So, Randy, just run up to New York and knock that out real quick with the quickness. If anyone is heading through Wisconsin, there's a massive pileup on 94. Mile marker 88 is shut down. Okay, thank you. Appreciate that, Mark. Mark had a good update for everybody. If anybody's going through Wisconsin on 94 around mile marker 88, not a good idea. Find a way around it. Find a way around it. You're living in that fucking FEMA trailer, Scott. Why would you want to sell your damn trailer? Timothy! My main man is in the house. What's really going on, player from Mahair? You know, we all support our women and we'll fix and go home and run off with our friends and neglect our women. Yeah. I will sell my camper to you for $9,000. That's all. Just $9,000. All it needs is a hot water heater. On in my trailer. Toy hauler. Pull behind. Brand new four tires. Get a house for yourself. That's what you need to do. We're just hanging out, Cheyenne. Just bullshitting. No big deal. It's all good in the neighborhood. I'm hungry again. Son of a... Tasha's in the house. How you doing? It's a 2008 Dutchman. Dutchman makes a pretty good camper. Hungry people. I'm hungry. Okay, now, whichever one of you sons of bitches gave me the advice to go to Dollar Tree to get some baby wipes, I got news for you. They got like three baby wipes. They're all singles. Like about that thick for like $400. I got me a roll of paper towels and some paper plates. Oh yeah. And some sanitizing hand wipes with 25% more. It smells so good. I mean, it smells so damn good. And they're really tough too, man. I mean, they're tough. But I needed something up here to wipe off my fucking hands. I'm always getting the diesel on my hands and shit like that. I needed something that was better for my fair complexion and my very tender skin. That's what I needed. That's what I got. Doing all right. Chainsaw said he's looking for a camper, Smooth. He'd get it hooked up with you. Holy cow. What do you say holy cow about? Dr. Mortician from Dalton. Worked security at Tunnel Hill before you went off to school. You talking about CDL school? But what? Split. That the one with the butt wipes. Gorgeous. 400. No, I was just, Tasha, I was just saying that they didn't have baby wipes, man. Like a real thin little single packages, man. It looked like something that you would just pick up if, like, you were out and about and you figured out that you had forgotten the baby wipes at the house and you got to just run into Dollar Tree and grab a quick little pack to cover you while you're out at the park or some shit like that. Nothing I would... See, I stack that shit in here, okay? I open up a cabinet and I stack them up. Because whenever I'm out there and I've been lazy and not stopped and got my shower during the day, when I wake up, man, I got to hit the important parts, you know, till I can make it to the next stop. You know, I've taken full, you know, baths with them damn things before, but having one or two little bitty packs ain't gonna help me. I'll go through that in like 15 minutes. You know what I'm saying? All right, mortuary school in Alabama. Well, of course you met a lot of drivers. Shitload of drivers going through there. Yep, the mortuary business, man. It's a banging business. Everybody's dying to get in, buddy. That's the shit. Wally World. Yeah, Tasha, I was parked between Wally World and Dollar Tree, okay? The Wally World was a little bit further, and then I had somebody come on last night and said, try Dollar Tree. And I'd already got out, got into Dollar Tree, and I wasn't going to go over to Walmart, but, you know, I had to. I'm like, I got to go over there. And then I spotted the vape shop. Yeah. So, as many of you know, so I didn't get to go get the baby wipes because I got tied up at the vape shop. Still, the same old poofer. My pluggy, man, it's getting harder and harder to charge my little battery. So I came up with plan B. Plan A sucked. Plan B, better. I bought more batteries and a cute little battery charger. Now I got 4 batteries. Winning. Whee! Hang on here. All right. I already got these two. One in the poofer, one in the hole over here. This is the cutest little thing, man. That's the battery charger, man. You just put the battery in there. It lights up right there, man. It lights up right there. It tells you when they're charged and whatnot. Winning. Just keep it right here, man. I always got batteries. And these new batteries, these green ones, see, they're real easy to put in, man. I just swing that dude to the side, pop it out with the little thing-a-ling right there. Bada-bing, bada-boom, baby. Is it me or did James freeze up? It's you. Oh, cool, it's got a slide-out smooth? Yeah, you gotta do that. What did you expect for a dollar? There, everything's a dollar. That's what the sign said. Everything's a damn dollar. I don't think they gave me a damn receipt. I don't know. I might have got taken. He's being funny. Yeah, Tasha? Yeah, Tim? Is it snowing in Ohio? was, but it stopped. Job security for sure. You're damn right. Everybody's dying to get in there, brother. Everybody's dying to get in there. Cheyenne, God dang, man. No, Tasha, no. Vaping isn't worse than smoking. See, vape, it's the juice, as long as you're not buying that Chinese juice, because they're trying to fucking kill us. I'm not joking, man. They put shit in our stuff that's coming over here, like they coat shit with lead and whatnot. They're trying to undermine our life here. You going to buy something that says made in China? You're seriously, all bullshit aside, you're taking your life in your own hands. But no, I grabbed me some juice. I grabbed me another little thing of juice. It probably says made in China on the side. Then it might be worse for me, because I'm getting low on my juice, see? And I can't stop. I gotta keep moving, you know, because that's what I do. I drive a truck. So the vaping just has like vegetable oil and the nicotine and whatever flavor, okay? But the cigarettes, they specifically have, and it is on record, they specifically have chemicals that are designed to addict you. It's not the nicotine, it's the chemicals they put in there, and it's a whole laundry list of chemicals that they put in the cigarettes. Plus the fact that it's actual burning and it's smoke going in, it'll fucker up your lungs. This is not smoke. This is vapor. It's vaporizing. And if you work in, let's say you worked at McDonald's and you're walking through McDonald's and you're breathing, that vegetable oil is bubbling and burling and you know that steam that's coming off, it's the same shit. It's just burning vegetable oil. You work at McDonald's, you're getting the same shit. So if this is bad for you, so is working at McDonald's and Dairy Queen and all them places. Yeah, true story. Charge your batteries for your poop. It's a poofer, not a pooper. Actual charger. You can cause a fire by using the port. You know, people have said that. They even said that, you know, that was a bad way to charge and shit like that. Well, why the fuck did they put it on there? If it's a bad way to charge, why the fuck did he put... Yeah, they didn't put it on there so I could charge other shit off of this battery. They put it on there so I could plug that sumbitch in. And bada bing, bada boom. Yeah, but luckily, this thing is all fuckered up now to the point where I'm pissed off at it and I done threw my damn cord back there. So, yeah, batteries. It's the future. It's the future. Batteries. Sounds like a girl that likes to spread her legs for every man in here. So... sounds like Luke Matthews is undercover Chance Wainscott. I smoke menthol and been smoking 3 packs a day. Think about US Xpress quit smoking program. Get it, Tasha, get it. Hell to the yes. Take what they got to offer. They give you free money for that shit too. And I would consider two things. I would consider a poofer and bring yourself down. And don't smoke the poofer, you know, just use it for the nicotine to. But, Chantix, I mean, it can drive you crazy and you can kill your family and shit, I think, but, yeah, that's what I heard. I don't know, I hear shit. It can drive you nuts, the Chantix, but if you can handle the Chantix will bring you down too. Yeah, get 3 packs a day. Jesus fucking Christ. God. Yeah, that's a lot of cigarettes, man. Oh my God. Yes, take what they're offering you. They have a mentor, a coach that'll walk through you with it, walk you through it and help you with it and shit like that. Kind of like gambling. But gambling ain't as bad for your health unless you're into a bookie for a lot of money and don't want to pay them sons of bitches. They'll break your damn legs. I heard that too. I never experienced that. I've never had a gambling problem for y'all, so don't even go over there. Not every man just had a great time. Yep. Later, Cheyenne. Take care. You be good. It's more a hand habit. You know, Tosh, it's a driving habit for me, man. You know, I get in, I start to drive, man, I roll the window down every once in a while, reach up for a pack of cigarettes, swear to God. Every once in a while, it'll happen. The poofer, though, smoking, it's not just a physiological habit that you take on, a physiological need that you have, but it's also a habit, like you say, a finger habit. Habits are easy to break. The thing about habits, they're like a rut in the road, okay? And you got your car, and it's in this rut, and you know, you're driving down the road because all the cars go down this road. What you have to break a habit is another rut. You have to get out of that rut and form a new one. I laid my pack of cigarettes and my lighter down. I put them menthols on the top shelf. I remember it like it was yesterday, man. Closed that cabinet, picked up the poofer, and never went back. And then when I went back to the cabinet, they were gone because Peggy's mama steals every damn thing. She stole my cigarettes, which was all right. That's no big deal. I didn't need it. Yes. Apparently, Lickety Split loves Shy too. We all love Shy. See you later, Shy. It wasn't enough. You can't use it like a cigarette. Mine was shaped like a cigarette. You know, it was a fucking pen, you know. And I sucked that thing down. I just sucked that, you know, like a crackhead wanting his next fix, you know, just sucking away. That's not what it's for. You got to form the next habit. If it's the hand, the finger, the shit like that, I don't know. Seriously, maybe mine was kind of, I don't remember that part very well. I know I had that fucking thing in my pocket and I was constantly picking it up. I know it was hard. I get that. Especially three packs. Jesus Christ. Okay. Lung cancer is much harder. You want to get motivated? Go look at some pictures of some people's lungs after they done smoked three packs a day for a while. Black lung like a motherfucker. But that cancer, man, you don't get rid of that shit. It kicks your ass like crazy and won't go away. They have to go cutting on you due to the radiation. Your hair falls out. Sometimes you lose a boob. Tosh, I'm telling you, man, anything's better than cigarettes. Anything. Just motivate yourself that you gotta stop. You gotta stop. I'm here for you. I'm be praying for you, of course. Everybody here will too. But you really need to, anything else. And I know you probably get pissed off whenever you put your cigarettes down, you try to quit, man, and everything just pisses you off, man. People are breathing and it's like, I want to fucking kill you. I get that. Been there, done that. That's just your body, the physiological part. You can get past that with these, and this might even have kind of a hand thing for you. Might form a new habit. You need a new rut though. You got to get away from that shit. Made you hack your rear end off. I still cough with these in the mornings. I do, but not nearly as much as when I was smoking. And it's never, I never have anything come up. It's not a productive cough. Hell, it could be just me fucking snoring and, you know, spit in the throat or something. I don't know. I hack every morning, you know, but it's not hard hacking like when I was smoking, you know. It's just like, you know, I wake up. If I'm laying down, that's when that's when it bothers me. Once I set up and I'm up for a while, it don't bother me no more. That's true fact. Called Salt Nick. you'd look into an online chick, would you look a vape shop? Yes, that salt business. Like what he said, the salt business. Yeah, it's stronger. Yeah. Great flavors, all of that. He is right, Tasha. He is right. New filters. Y'all are funny, man. Y'all are some funny some bitches, man. Stage 2 emphysema, COP. Oh, man, that's another thing, man. Toting that fucking oxygen around. Oh, God, man. I can't even imagine that, man. And they even got some newer, lightweight shit you can wear around and shit like that. But, you know, that's like... that. I knew somebody that tried to teach their dog not to kill the chickens. He killed a chicken, so they tied the dead chicken around his neck. That's why I think that oxygen is for you. It's like tying a dead chicken around your neck. Teach you not to smoke. It's like, bitch, it's too late. You know, I'm already on this shit. The emphysema and all that shit. That you're done. Chronic obstructed pulmonary disease, COPD, and emphysema. You don't get rid of them. You're on oxygen. You're fucked up for the rest of your life. The lung cancer, when they have to take a big chunk of lung out or swap out your lungs with some dead person that left them to you. That's not a stop smoking, girl. Lay them down. Just put it down. Just put them down. Anything's better than that, man. Anything. I've watched all of my people smoke like nobody's business. I watched all of my people go through all that shit, man. No. That's awful. I couldn't wish that on my worst enemy, man. It's a terrible life to have to do that, to go through that. Lay it down. Lay them down. Find anything. Get Chantix, man. Try Chantix first. Get after the Chantix. You got the insurance? Get that Chantix. See if the Chantix is on the insurance. Yes, please. For me. That's just funny. Y'all being funny on there. Two different inhalers? Yeah, it's an awful thing. God, man. I used to haul a lot of folks to the hospital in the back of the ambulance. It gave you horrible fucking nightmares? Well, you're psychotic anyway, so it might not have been the Chantix if you think about it. I'd reevaluate that shit. Oh, yeah. Hell, yeah. Fuck, yeah. But you got to run away from that shit, too. Have you seen the people that get the cancer from the chewing and the dipping and shit like that? And they take off. They have to take bone and every damn thing. There's just, like, nothing there.
Yeah, I guess. They talk like this, man.
Lose all your damn teeth and every damn thing. They just take every fucking thing out. Take big chunks. They try to skin graft over with, you know, a slice off your ass. So you got ass attached to your face. Stop that shit. Put it down. Every time you want to dip, I don't know, because I think Josh still dips today. Fuck, I don't know what to do about dipping. I dipped like twice in my life. Both times I turned green, threw my guts up for like 30 minutes. Mm-mm. Oh, yeah. Yeah, Ding Dong's been looking for that ready cut skull. Yeah, I forgot all about that. Hey, one time and it worked. He hasn't smoked in like 18 years. Well, you got a 50-50 chance then. Because you've got both their DNA. You got a 50-50 chance. Think about that. Them's some pretty good odds. That's better than winning the lottery odds. You heard me? With the lottery, you got a better chance of getting hit on a boat by lightning, falling into the water and getting shark attacked. Seriously. I mean, terrible fucking odds. You got 50-50 chance right there. I'd go for it. Stick with meth? Yeah, me too. Yeah, I would stick with meth. It's much better for you than tobacco. Yeah, Tosh, I'm serious when I say this. There are so many folks that I even seen people in the nursing homes. They wouldn't let them have cigarettes, and they offer me money. Will you go get me a cigarette? No, you can't smoke in here. You know, you're dropping off a patient, at your ambulance, take them back from the hospital over to the nursing home, go in there and, you give me a cigarette? No, I can't do that. I'll give you money. You know what would have been worse, but offering me money and stuff like that, that was bad enough. You feel bad, but it's like, no. And I'm not going to contribute. I'm not. After I stop smoking, fuck no. I will not go to the store and buy you a pack of cigarettes. I will not stand there while you buy a pack of cigarettes next to me and look at me and ask me a damn question. I'll leave. I'm not a militant non-smoker. I live with a militant non-smoker. It's just smoking. It's not just bad for your health. It's bad for everything around you and everyone around you. Makes your clothes stink, your house stink, your truck stink. It makes everything stinky, and it won't go away. It just won't go away. Well, yeah, my grandfather smoked. He died of the cancer too. He smoked them Pall Malls, no filter Pall Malls. My entire life, I remember. And I can't tell you how many times he was in the hospital and they were cutting on him, cutting him up, trying to save his life. Chemo and all the other damn things that whatever the hell they did. When what finally got him is it metastasized and it got into his bloodstream and went everywhere and it hit his liver. And the minute it hit his liver, he turned like orange. What the hell you call that? That jaundice? Yeah. That's when they took him to the hospital. And at the same time they're taking him to the hospital, they're coming to get me because they knew it was over. And they brought me into his room. I was the last grandchild to see him alive. He told me, he loved me before he died. That was his last words to me. I love you. And it wasn't I want a cigarette. It's I love you. But knowing what I know and still smoked, I was such a fool. I was so stupid. So stupid. And I don't want that for anybody else. I don't want your children and grandchildren's visiting you in a hospital and you're fucking orange and you can't you can't even talk and the last words out of your mouth are I love you before you go on off to your respective next life. No, I don't want that for you. Lay them cigarettes down. Do it now. You get a poofer. Whatever you gotta do. It don't matter, man. I mean, I don't know. I don't advocate things unless, somebody I know has had a positive. That's why I say the Chantix. I don't know, man. I got to put that little warning label, attach it to that. Because, I've heard people, got psychotic on that shit. But and even says in the commercials, when they're, the Chantix commercials, it says if you feel like homicide, well, I'm paraphrasing here, but if you feel like homicide or suicide, contact some fucking body. Yeah. So, but I mean, if you got to go to the extreme, do what you do. Oh, cool. There you go. Tasha, Heisenberg, baby. Heisenberg. I don't think that was his name. I don't think it was Heisenberg. No. That doesn't sound right. Heisenberg. Maybe it was. Could have been. They asked James for cigs and sex. Who does? Them old people? No sex. Just the cigarettes. Lucky strikes. Whew. I think they made lucky strikes out of anything they could find around the fucking factory, man. They went and cut the grass, got some hay. Yeah. Johnny. Smooth went to that Johnny. Man, best investment ever in batteries, man. This is rocking and rolling now. I'm getting a strong... I'm going to have to turn this shit down, man. I'm getting too strong of a hit. Fucking awesome, man. Let's go to 7.5. Let's go to 7.5. Smooth. Ah, pardon the pun. Ha! Get high. If I smoke a cigarette, man, it sends me some fucking where else, man. Oh, shit. Oh, cheat. All right. See what my daughter did? Let me tell y'all what she did. I'm gonna throw her under the bus real quick. The first thing they did. Yeah. Baby wipes. That's another reason I have them on the truck, man, because they don't hand them out at the truck stop. You gotta have your baby wipes, man. You know, you get through in there, and then you gotta come out here, you gotta finish it up. Rest areas, I carry my packet into the rest area, okay? I don't mess around. I go in there, I get through the business, man. I make sure everything's sanitary. And no, these are not gonna touch my honey, cause they're antibacterial, and I feel like it will hurt. Just FYI, you don't do that. Don't for the fucking hands. They say hands. Pretty sure they said hands for the hands. There it is. I want to get some more of these because they smell so fucking good. What do we got in there? We got some alcohol. Oh hell, we got shit in there. I don't even know what it is. No, you don't flush the wipes, man. You get the baby smelling ones that smell real good. That way, when you're cleaning up after the go, as they say on the commercial, you just fold that dude up, throw it in your toilet or your trash can, because they smell so fucking good. They knock all that rest of that shit down. Hey, if you're gonna put it on your baby's ass, that delicate little booty, if you're gonna wipe the baby, you know, and whatnot, and just throw that shit away, why not? You can put it in the trash can. Same thing. You're wiping the big baby. I know I'm talking about people. I know. I'm a professional. I can't see, but I'm still a professional. What the fuck is this? Oh shit, this sounds like something that'll kill somebody. I hate big words like this. Yeah, no. They ain't going nowhere near my honey. All right, y'all. Let's see. Yeah, I got them. Here we go. Holy shit. That's a big word. Benzalkonium chloride. Shit. Now I'm gonna have to go look that up. I don't know what the fuck that is. That's the antibacterial. It says the inactive ingredients is water, SD alcohol 40. What is SD alcohol? Yeah, that's true. Propylene glycol, allobarba. Jesus Christ, man. They got 463 different inactive ingredients. Some potassium sorbate. I don't even know what that is. Made in China. See, I fucking told you. Made in China. This shit'll kill you, man. But, you know, I only got to use, it's a 75 count, and I've already used 2. So we're on our way to cleansing ourselves. Yeah, you got to clean the gooch. The whole kit and caboodle, your whole undercarriage. That's why you carry a pack of them baby wipes, man. You got to get everything. The gooch is important, too. You are correct, sir. What do we have for this gentleman? Man. We're eating nachos. That's what we're about to do. Let's go to the kitchen. Let's get some nachos. Woo. I felt coldness on my buttocks. Wrong one. Why am I in here? Ain't nothing in there for me. Yeah. Paper plates and a roll of paper towels. You always gotta have a roll of paper towels in your damn truck. Now I run out. I don't know how that happened. Because I'm usually real good at it. Alright. Don't nobody move. You gotta get two of them. Alright. Get in there with the rest of them. Stand by, all units stand by. Hey, she did give me a damn, what you call it. Yep, everything was a dollar. I buy that for a dollar. All right. Now, this is the nacho maker. We're probably going to go 2 or 3 times at this shit. I'm going to give you a step-by-step instruction on how to do this, all right? First, you get your microwave ready. Very important part of the process. Don't fall on me. You get your mild cheddar. What could be better? Alright. It's important that it's great value, mild cheddar. Does that taste like nachos to me? It might not be. It might not be a good thing, but it tastes like nachos to me. I'm a professional, so you can take my advice. Up in that cold ass frozen ass atmosphere. You know this ain't real cheese, right? Scientists still haven't figured out what it is. Alright. Now, the second important part of this is when you have chips that are that fuckered up, no. Nay. No! Sons of bitches! You need unbroken chips. Hey, follow my lead here, people. Wood chips? Probably. That don't really smell like corn chips right there. I don't know what the hell these are. Alright, then you grab you some. Get it. Yeah, get on there. All right. Big old chips. Some people, they substitute Tostitos for these. That's fine. It doesn't matter what kind of chips you get, just as long as you get the corn chips. Josh, you want it? Me to do some chef things, so here's the Trucker Chef with Trucking Cuisine, Baxter, Tennessee version, episode You arrange them, okay? It's important that they're arranged where they're damn near all touching. Because you don't want to waste any of your cheese. You don't want it to slide off on the plate. It'll stick to the plate. You heard me? Damn it, people. I'm trying to give you fucking gold here. You must risen. I said what? Running across the parking lot and get back in the truck. No, I don't run. I'm too old to run. That's why... That's why I use a 9mm. I'm too old to run. And when my eyes get too bad, that's when I start using a 12 gauge. 12 gauge. And I ain't got a seat. Ain't no running. These colors don't run. What? No. It's all good. It's all good. You don't need to... No. You need the camera up. Because I'm going to be standing up in just a second. This only takes a second here. All right. You getting the cheese, right? Of course it doesn't smell anything like cheese. And you're getting the handful of the cheese. I'm trying to teach y'all the fucking basics here, man. You can expand on this. Alright, and then you just kind of sprinkle it all around. You don't want to get it all over the place. You just want to get it on the chips. It's important. We're making nachos, y'all. I haven't tried it, but I'll shake a little bit of that Frank's Red Hot on there and see what it tastes like. I probably won't like it, because I like this flavor. Alright. See, we didn't use very much. I'll show y'all. Yes, you're going to have fucking cheese all over your hands. But wait. It's not really cheese. So, who really cares? Then you get in the white, and you get the ones here that break off. That's why you get this special decanter here. And then you're taking your mystery wipe and you're wiping the cheese off. You're wiping the cheese off. The imitation cheese, the wannabe cheese. Got to get between your fingers because it will work its way between the fingers. You heard me? All right. So now, here's what we're set up with. There. See? You're getting the cheese. You be generous with your cheese. Alright, you be generous with the cheese. Alright, it's important. Because it's all grated up and whatnot. Look out. I'm trying to carry everything back here with me. Boom. 30 seconds. Alright. Woo! Doggies. Fucking cheese everywhere. Alright. Another important part of this is you gotta let the air out of this wannabe cheese. You gotta press it and then close it. It takes up a hell of a lot less room in the refrigerator. And you always have a little bitty backup pack just in case you run out of the big one. But that's just, personal. Don't, whatever you do, don't go to Dollar General and get the Velveeta and think it's going to have the same taste and flavor and everything as the Great Value. It's not. It's just not. It's not good. It's not good at all. Either one of them is going to kill you quick, but it just don't taste the same. So if I'm going to die slowly with this processed-ass food, I'm gonna do it in a way where it's a tasting good, it's feeling good. All right. We had 30 seconds, but we were generous with the cheese. And I'm using the word cheese generously. We were generous with the cheese, so we want it melted. So we're going to give it another 30, but we're not going to leave it in there for all that time. Okay, there's your 15 seconds. Okay, we're bubbling. We're bubbling a little bit. All right, now, God dang, that smells good. See? See? You see it bubbling? You don't want to bubble too much because that shit will get hard. It'll get hard as a rock. And burn yourself. Shit like that. Yeah, Velveeta sucks. Hey, Ryan, how you doing? Oh, Jesus Christ, man. Okay, bud. No, it wasn't frozen. Because it's not real food. It won't freeze. That's another thing, man. If the shit don't freeze, it probably ain't real. Yeah, probably gonna get some mystery taste from the mystery wipes. You're right. Hey, now, wait a minute now. Wait a minute now. I don't think that shit's from China. Yeah, I think it might be plastic, but I don't think it's from China. I think it's from right here. What do I have no clue about till I sat down? Can't pick up the Kelly load until tomorrow. Yes. Yes, that is correct. Can't pick up the Cali load. They're closed, man. They're closed on Saturday and Sunday. They're only about like 15, 20 minutes right up the road. I'm real close now. First come, first serve. There's no appointment on that business either. Some kind of plastics place. I eyeballed it on the Googler. All right, see? See? Ain't that cool? That's the smell. That's what I'm looking for right there. That's it right there. Out of the park, man. Home run. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. When you do that and it goes, psh, you can smell. That's how you know it's good. Tip Height Crane Operator. How you doing? Now, Ryan, I not only didn't get to go over there early, we've had kind of a trailer thing going on. Oh, that's horrible. That's horrible. You're a long ways away, brother. Yeah, I need tires. Well, at least I feel like I need tires. Ooh, what's that? Got another one? How'd he get another one? Let's see if it's the imitation cheese messing with my taste buds. Vintage. Yep. I don't know. These were frozen. What? Another one? Oh, shit. Where did you get all these from? Oh, there's no shh. I mean, it's flat, but I can taste it. Confused now. That's the last one. All right, bubble cup juice it is, or water. How about that? 340. Another 10 and you'd have a Robbie. Yeah, shit. I don't care. I'm eating it. Cause it just tastes so damn good. If I were closer. But 10 more, you get a Robbie Stockman, man. Tree bitty. I ain't gonna get none of that Chinese chemical shit on my damn tongue. Fuck that. Probably getting enough of it on my damn chip. You would be wrong. You would be way, way wrong, Joshua. I don't like feet. Feet are nasty. I don't care how much I love that woman. If you go take a bath, I'll watch you take a bath and wash your feet. I might rub your feet. Don't put your fucking feet on me. Don't touch me with your feet. I'll fuck you up. Feet are fucking nasty. I'll fucking shoot your toes off. You know, feet stink for a reason. You're not supposed to go near them. Like dead animals, you ain't supposed to go near them. There's shit for that. No, you don't. You ain't got no stories. Funny thing is, there's plenty of room to back up here. People keep pulling across the fucking scale to get in these fucking... There's three spaces beside me. Three. And Pam over here is... Damn it. I'm talking about shit. I ain't showing y'all. He's coming across the damn scale. Ain't that some shit? And yeah, he missed. He's coming in next to me, and that truck is squarely right on that line, right in the middle. I've become such a freaking asshole about people backing. Now I gotta have to pull out again. Bro. I'm gonna start backing these trailers in for these people, man. I'm gonna jump out and say, let me back that in for you, man. I don't know why I think feet are so damn nasty. I don't know. But they just are. That's a female driver. She got it in there. I ain't trying to talk shit about her. But I ain't gonna say she didn't scare me. Why would I knock female drivers? There's safest drivers out there. Dudes take chances that females just won't. I guess. At least be, yeah, by being beside me, ain't nobody going back on that side. That side. Yeah. male drivers, they've got so many idiosyncrasies. And women are just work oriented. Go out, get the job done, get it over with. They probably do. I've seen a couple female drivers that'll whip it into a spot. Now the thing about female drivers, they have a hell of a time learning to back. I mean, that the absolute longest and most intensive amount of training that I've ever given anybody was all my female students, because backing is not, they're not wired for it. Young dudes get a pickup truck and a damn trailer. Now try, it didn't work. They try something else, didn't work. They figure out real quick that this is what I need to do, and then they put it in there. And they grow up and they do the same thing with the big truck. Females, it just does not compute. But once they've practiced, once they've hit it, got the confidence, and they practice that, keep after it, they build on what they've learned. They drive safer in forward gear. They back slower in reverse. They're more conscientious. They have less ego, so they'll let somebody pass. They don't put themselves in situations where, like the dudes do. Dudes are definitely a menace on the highway, especially dudes with attitudes. 80,000 pound missile coming at you, baby. No, I don't think I'm ever gonna get some fucking tires. I'm headed to Cali, Mike. Going to Fairfield, California. I do it every once in a while. That's funny, Tyler. That's funny. I love teaming. But I didn't do it long enough where I would get tired of it. I'm pretty sure I'd get tired of it. Mike, you still there? It's time for oil field talk then. I've been watching really, really close. Well, that's cool. I've been watching really, really close lately. All right. Because I'm definitely gonna have to move that truck either next week or week after next whenever I get it fixed. I'm gonna have to move that Columbia over to another company from 1845. Seems like their shit's coming apart at the seams or something. I don't know what the hell's wrong over there. Just crazy. But got a lot of folks here, and me too. We're trying to figure out this company where these guys are pulling 3 to 4 to 5 loads a day. Y'all don't go crazy over the secret to how to do that and everything like that, because we know what the secret is. This company be conducive to something like that. They have no paper logs. No, I mean, you could run them if you have a 2000 or older truck. Like, I got that Pete, that's a 96. It worked. It'll make money, make a lot of money. But it's different than that. Exactly. I've been looking at all of that. And keep me in the loop, by the way, because I gotta go full tilt boogie in about a week or two. Diamond pump. I've got to find the company that I won't say. Anyway, that'll be conducive to getting a lot more runs every day, where I can put that Columbia out there running. See if Bobby's ready to take it over. If I find the company and lock in, then I'll go ahead and take the loan that's been offered me to fix the Pete, and I'll put it in the shop as soon as the Pete's ready. Bye-bye, Volvo. It's over. And I'll have 2 oil field trucks at that point. Struggling too damn hard with this bullshit. But I gotta have the right company to jump into. That's what I've heard. That's what Bobby told me. He used to haul it for, who'd he haul? I think he hauled it for Stallion or somebody. Yep, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Like, you gotta pump that damn water, that salt water, off of those tanks at all those well sites. And that has to happen constantly. For the life of the well, as long as it's pumping, shit's coming out of the ground. Exactly, you can take 15 day cabs down there and do it. Put you a fucking FEMA trailer out there in the middle of nowhere and a day cab and a couple of guys, and just rake that money in. Once again, gotta get on with the right company. Gotta know where to go. It's about pressing that flesh. Getting to know people. a lot of people will tell you it's a good old boy system. A lot of folks of color will tell you it's a good old boy system that has this kind of color skin. Bridger? Oh, yeah. Yeah, I've been watching some old boy that's either with Bridger or was with Bridger. If they'll take on owner ops, man, whatever works, I do not care. I will build a fucking house out there. I will buy a plot of land and build a fucking house and park trucks out there around that house. I do not give a shit. I want oil field money for a while. I'm playing catch up right now, and I ain't catching up. I'm getting further behind. I want the oil field money now. Not yesterday. Now. 1845 was a good start. I'll give it that. Is it 100 miles or is it 150 miles? And yeah, that would be the rule. Yes. Most of the, and frankly, 1845 should run under this for the wells that are in Texas. Most of the wells are only 60 miles from the sand plant. You go do what you do, Taji. We love you long time. Stop smoking, damn it. Jesus Christ, man. It's 60 miles. There's no reason to be on e-logs, man. Stupid. Break out a sheet of fucking paper and write that shit down. Impala. I don't know who that is. Never heard of them. That's why I keep telling y'all. I need to know who Kuyang 404 Trucker Dave went with and shit like that. Ain't nobody can tell you about that fucking net bullshit. There you go. I'm over the bullshit over at 1845. I'm over it, man. I feel like they were subversive. I feel like they were keeping information, hiding information, protecting somebody or something, protecting themselves. I don't know. I'm over that. I don't like that, man. If they had a big wig call me and say, I am going to instruct these people right now to get down to the bottom of this. If they can't, they can't. But at least, you know from the top that this shit's going to get looked into. We're not trying to hide anything. I would feel better about the company. The only good thing I got to say about them, they got some really nice hats, and I love their design. They piss me off. I can't handle that shit, man. It's like I don't matter. It's like I'm just, a fucking rotten banana thrown out with the fucking garbage, you know? Why do you ask, up? I ain't eating no more. Get on there. Yeah. Get on there, cow. Yeah, move, cow. Move. Making dinner. Woo! Awesome. Welcome to the room. Yeah, Scott, why do you want to know about the loves, man? You tell me what town he's in, whether it's Midland or Odessa, I'll tell you about that loves. I can do it. Mike, I wanted to talk to you about that. One of the last videos I watched was it was them hanging out at the truck stop. Don't know what truck stop, but they were hanging out at the truck stop, and that's when they said the CEO guy got in a truck and went over to him and started talking to him. And apparently, Chase and Andrew was live at that time, but his battery died, so he didn't get any of that on the live feed. But later, on Golden Child's channel, you can see them talking about it. And then, of course, you know, a week later, they got their cowboy hats on and those short sleeve fucking Walmart shirts, and they're talking about their new opportunity that came their way and shit like that. But they're getting one whale. Bobby said that Pilot bought Bridger out. FYI. Anyway, on Golden Child's video, he was talking about it. Talking about him leaving 1845 at that time, and also in the same video, Chase and Andrew was talking about in the month of January, he was at three different companies. 1845 slowed down, which we know from personal experience, me and Bobby. 1845 slowed down. So then he went somewhere else, and then he went to this company that he's at right now. And I swear he's at the same company as 404 Trucker Dave and Kuyang. I swear. And if you'll listen in that video, they will tell you, I do believe they're in Odessa. It seems like that one is, they didn't say anything about Midland. They said Odessa. I do believe. So it's just the Pilot in Odessa. I've been there 1,000 times. I don't remember it looking like that. I don't know where the fuck they are. I am wondering I don't know why I always get the idea that they're at a Stripes, not a Love's. Yeah, I was thinking the same thing, Mike. You know, even with them not providing the fuel cards, which, like he said, that's 40 grand a week that they gotta pay, whether the trucks, you know, make money and get it back to them or not. Which it's almost a guarantee they'll get the money back as long as the trucks keep working for them. But when you provide a card to people and they got an exit strategy, they fill up their truck and leave, now you're on the hook for that $500-$600. Out there, it's $600 or $700. Because fuel out there is a good 30 cents to 50 cents a gallon more than it is anywhere else in Texas. It's high as giraffe booty out there. Not everywhere out there, but at the, you know, at the chains and stuff like that, most places you want to fill up. I think the most I've ever paid, other than California, for fuel, I paid in Carlsbad, New Mexico. they raped my ass. Yes, they did. And I was low on fuel, too, so I took it. I took it deep and hard. God damn, it was expensive. Oh, my God. And cold, too. It was cold as hell. It's one of the reasons they run the ELDs is crossing that state line going into New Mexico for the whale at Jaw, or the whales, plural, at Jaw. Well, yeah, no. I know what you're talking about. You're talking about $300 a week per truck for insurance alone. The DOT stuff, forget about it. IFTA stuff, that's down the road. It'll jack them on that IFTA stuff too. But that's down the road. Forget about it. They were talking about providing plates, IFTA, the whole nine yards. I'm like, dude, conservatively, $50 a truck just for signage. Times 40 trucks, man. Think about that. And he said he don't have the money for, you know, for the fuel. I don't know where you're going to get these people bringing in their own fuel cards in the first place. They're not going to have money to run. They're going to be coming at you for advances. You know, I feel like unless they're hopping from another company, unless they're hopping for, they're already out there. They got money in their pockets and they're hopping from a company to yours, and they already got fuel cards or a lot of money in the bank, you know, or some really good credit or some shit. But now you're going to have to make payroll at the end of the week, and you ain't got paid. That's, man, 40 trucks, man, that is a lot. And I realize Golden Child's a very intelligent human being, and that's not, no, I'm not, throwing any shade on Andrew. Andrew's obviously a pretty smart feller himself. They're two smart fellers. But this is a scale. This is a scale you got to work up to. Seriously, man. 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 10 trucks, 20 trucks. You got to work up to that. One day, suddenly going to put 40 trucks on the road. Then they said they got like, what, 20 acres out there? An office with 20 acres to park these trucks and shit like that? Now you're going to have people processing all that DOT stuff, and they got to keep up with it. Compliance is a motherfucker. Ask me how I know. You got compliance. You've got safety. And you got to write a fucking book. You have to write a book. Because all those safety regulations don't mean shit when the man comes in there after one of these dickheads has a wreck. They want to see the book. They want to see where you showed them these are our fucking rules. You need the book. You know, you need your safety guidelines. Oh, man, just... I mean, I can't even imagine that. Just all of a sudden, one day, it's 40. And you say you ain't got the money for the fuel cards. I get that. But if you ain't got the money for the fuel cards, how do you get the money for that 20 acres and the fucking office and the people that are going to have to inhabit it? Because you can't do it. You and Golden Child can't do it. Those two, y'all, No, no, you got two gentlemen that are going to try to handle all that? No, you got to hire somebody. Well, now you're paying taxes. There's W-2 right there, and you're going to have a few of those. Having a backer, you're going to have to go to your backer and say, I need a line of credit. You know, I need money in the bank, sitting in the bank, ready to pay for shit. I'm not saying they haven't done that. I'm just saying, for me, I think big. I do. I think like a millionaire or a billionaire. Because, I mean, if you think like a street urchin, that's all you're going to be. You think like a $20 or a $100 heir, that's all you're going to be. You think like a millionaire, well, that's where you'll get to. You just got to think big. I think big. I go big or I go home. You think 5 to 6 mil to start? I mean, I think that's on the high side. Because you don't have any equipment cost as far as the trucks and shit like that, except for, you know, just putting stickers on the side. And the ELD is going to be about $200-$300 a piece if they go ELD. And I heard them say out loud they weren't going to do that whole pluggy thing, or they were considering not doing the pluggy thing. I don't know about the file bankruptcy. I think just run when they see what it is. Well, if you self-insure, what is the self-insurance? It's you got to have a bond of what? It's only like, is it 50,000 or 250,000? But the self-insurance thing, that bond, it's not that much, relatively speaking. 1 mil? Backer can cover that. Mm-hmm. But that's one whale, dude. And them whales go down every day. It's like setting yourself up for failure. Man, that is... Look, I don't go to casinos. Okay, I like to go in there every once in a while. Because they got free drinks. And I'll play a few games. I'm not a gambler. I gambled on this shit and lost. And this ain't that big. I mean, you gamble with things. But that's not... That's not... Man. And when you don't have the experience of running a large fleet like that, what is Golden Child got? And I'm not chucking any shade at him, please, believe me. And if you see this Golden Child or Chasing Andrew, I'm not chucking any shade at you guys. I mean, this is a big, giant shit sandwich you're taking a bite out of, man. I'm worried for you. I'd be praying for you every damn day. And I pray that you're successful. Believe me, I pray that you're successful. Oh man, I'm a gambler to a degree when it comes to business, but my God, man, that is a huge, huge thing that how many Golden Child, what, got three trucks? Is it three? Yeah, well, I don't know if they're all broke down. I think he said one of them's ready right now. One or two of them, but he lost a driver. Eat dinner, ready fish release. Well, you just go do that, Tuckster. You just go do that. We see you later. Running three trucks. Been there, done that. What a fucking cluster. Running 40 trucks. They never mention anything about a dispatcher. Wells are 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. You gotta have somebody dispatching. Somebody that answers the phone and sends the trucks to the well. If there's a problem, somebody answers the phone and handles that problem. Well, Scott, you're saying they buy junk trucks. They are, they're not too far off the mindset that I have. I don't like DPF systems. I do not like all that fucking junk over there that is going to cost you $8,000 to $10,000 soon. I don't like the one box. I don't like that whole fucking thing. And you idle, it fuckers it up, because that DPF system is designed it to clean itself out. It's self-cleaning as long as you're at highway speed running. That's what it's designed to do. I mean, it's got a lot of working parts along with that. You stop for 24, well, you stop for 10 hours a night. You stop for an additional 24 hours on top of that 10, 34 hours. That sumbitch is clogging up. Regen, that's just a sign that things are going bad. And then a year or two down the line, that one box gets all corroded up in there or some shit. And you're just asking for problems with that. It's one more thing that you don't need. That's why I bought that Columbia. It's 2005, no DPF, can fucking idle indefinitely. As long as I got fuel in it, it can just idle. It can just go, just sit there. I don't give a shit, because I'm not gonna clog anything up. It's the way that it is. Exactly. The worst problems that I had with that 2012 Cascadia when I got it, and I knew there were going to be problems, was the DPF system. It derated. Fucking derated down to 5 mile an hour, would not go. Just way. Hell, I've had DPF problems with this. It's 2 years old. They buy those trucks cash because they make more money. They put more money into the maintenance fund because they know a truck is going to break down, and then they're going to have extra money to cover that breakdown. And I will add a little footnote. There's no way I would put a new truck that I'm buying out in the oil fields. It's just going to get all fuckered up. Going to have no resale value whatsoever. You'd have to have somebody cosmetically come in and just totally go over the whole fucking thing and just all kinds of paint and shit like that. No. You put a raggedy ass truck out there, because it's just going to get fucked up while it's out there. It's science. That's the way it is. And there you are, and you own it outright. Every dollar it makes, and they said this on the video too, but every dollar it makes, that's a dollar in your pocket, but while it's sitting, you're not losing anything. I think you're losing something. If you ain't running, you're losing $1,000 a day potential revenue, you know, just drive-in alone. But you don't have a payment. You're not getting behind, per se. Insurance is going to come at you no matter what kind of fucking truck you buy. You can't get away from that. I think it's very important if you're going to go that route. Yeah, 3 months, paid for itself. Exactly. If you're going to go with an older truck, which is my advice too, frankly, if you're going to go with an older truck, do your research into parts and labor and whatnot, and availability of parts is most important right there. But the availability of specific kinds of mechanics that can work on your engine. Like that damn Columbia, it's got a Brazilian engine in it. It's got a fucking Mercedes Benz. Nobody likes these things, no, and including me. But this particular Mercedes Benz was just built, rebuilt from the ground up the year before. So I knew by the time I had a problem with that Mercedes Benz, the truck would have paid for itself. I can't tell you that it's paid for itself, because I've had some less than desirable drivers in that truck. It can pay for itself now. It can definitely pay for itself now. No problem. I could pay that fucking truck off in 2 months. You know, I mean, just outstanding truck. You know, great tread all the way around. You can eat off the engine. Nothing wrong with that truck, except that little air leaky things that those sons of bitches at the TA that raped me for $2,400 did not put they didn't put any of that Teflon tape on my on my air fittings when they replaced the air dryer. It is what it is, man. You get what you get. Shoddy fucking repairs. But, I would strongly, more than strongly, it's just the best thing to do. It really is. It's the best thing to do. To get an older truck, put it out there, keep up on the maintenance, get it maintained real well before you ever put it out there. Because maintenance out there is going to cost you more, by the way. But get it together, get it going, bada bing, bada boom. Yeah, yeah, you guessed it. Yeah, yeah, Chance was in it. It's odd, you know, I mean, I can't see that air compressor going out because of Chance. I don't think that had anything to do with Chance. Nor, just like the damn fan blade, you know, coming apart and exploding, taking out the damn radiator, had anything to do with Bobby. Bobby just happened to be in the truck behind the wheel when it happened. It has nothing to do with his driving. Yeah, that's true. I mean, he could not be blamed for that. And, you know, of course, Bobby can't be blamed for any of the fucking mishaps that happened while we were out there. He gets hit from behind doing everything perfectly legal. He gets backed into while he's in the bunk asleep. The fan comes apart right after he gets the truck and he's running. And he never complained. That is a driver. He never complained. He was off for a week while we were trying to get that damn radiator mailed, shipped out from Dallas out to New Mexico. He stayed at the damn little bitty mini pilot there in Jal, New Mexico. Never complained. Watched his little videos on the inside of the place because he couldn't run the truck. The fucking fan done exploded and took out the fucking radiator. Couldn't run the truck. It's cold as fuck out there. He likes it cold. But he's a true Marine. Yes, he is a true Marine, and he's one hell of a driver. He can get it done. And he can outwork you. He ain't afraid of work. He loves to run. He loves to do that shit. That's why I want to go back out there. I want to go back out there, but I want to go out there with him. I want to go at this like a double barrel shotgun, man. Just fucking hit it hard, man. Hit it hard. Oh, he's still going above and beyond. He's still going above and beyond. Right now, the minute the money comes in, the insurance money comes in, he's going to take off. Hopefully, it'll be right at his day off. He's going to take off from Louisiana, come right over there and help me fix that motherfucker. And I'm going to take him up on it, too. I don't know. Them hoods is heavy. We're gonna put that damn thing right back together. Get it right back on the road. No problem. No problem. Once I build up a little bit of capital, I'm gonna get a little piece of land out there to park the trucks on, and maybe put a FEMA trailer or two, you know, some solar, you know, some water and shit like that, off grid, but everything you need, and have a nice little spot out there. That way we can just drive out there in our personal cars, and it'll be better. Just drive out there, and we got a place to go. If we're close to the well, we got a place to go at night, whatever. Yeah, fly down. Not checking the air in the tires was a biggie. Yeah, man, come on out, man. See, I'm not afraid to go and get some of those maintenance lease trucks from like Penske and Ryder and shit like that, throw a couple of those in the mix, I'm not afraid to do all that shit. That's why I, you know, with Mike and stuff like that, running under an alternative authority, working third party for somebody that's got a contract coming in and being strong for them so they can see that your guys, you know, kick ass and take names. Fuck yeah, man. Take it over. And honestly, that could build up to 40 trucks in a heartbeat. And I don't mean me having 40 trucks. Fuck that noise. No. You keep that shit. I don't want more than 10, and that's a fucking headache. Hell, I had 2, and that was a fucking headache. Big ass headache. More than I can handle kind of headache. But I was driving at the same time, too. So, yeah. If I wasn't in the truck, if I wasn't driving, if I was just like a backup driver or something, yeah, I don't mind going out there. I don't mind any of that shit. Kicking ass, taking names, man. The day truck idea, throwing on a couple day trucks out there, running water at the same time we're running sand. Fuck yeah, man. Everybody's employed, no matter what. You're a fucking driver. Get out there, man. Fucking go deliver this shit. Keep you working, man. Keep the money coming in. That's what keeps a driver happy. Keep that money moving. Man, I need to go home, man. I'm tired as fuck. Well, fuck, hang on, man. Get on the phone. All right, your flight's ready, man. Just take the fucking company van. Go to the airport, man. Jump on the fucking flight. Go home. Fucking, I don't care. Just get back. Go, you know, smoke some meth, whatever the fuck you're going to do at home, and come back with the quickness, man. We need you out here. Let's get this. That's the kind of place I like to work. By God, that's kind of place I put together. That's kind of operation I put together. Fuck that. Yeah, I'm not taking Zeus out there. He'll fucking die. He's got so much fucking hair, man. He'll fucking die. 3's a good number. 3's a good number. But I get the right folks, man. You get the right folks out there, and they're out there, and they're you know, they're really trying to make money. They're not riding a fucking clock and shit like that. Not getting frustrated because wells go down, and you know, there's always some kind of fucking problem out there. Trying to keep it between the mayonnaise and the mustard, and keep the other motherfuckers off of you. It's not hard. It's really not hard. Shut up, dickhead. You can work for 4 weeks and go home for 3 days. How about that? And jump on a fucking airplane right there. Midland, Odessa, they got a fucking airport. Jump on an airplane. You might have to, like, take a connecting flight. You know, they fly into, like, Love Field or DFW there in Dallas and then take a connecting flight up. But when I got into the oil field back in 2015... and didn't actually get into the oil field, just got my training and shit like that, and then it just went bust, and they lost their contracts and shit like that over at Outlaw. I don't even know why. I do not need to be running. I don't need that shit. One of the individuals that turned me on to that place, he lived in Florida. He flew to Florida. He'd come out, work for a few weeks, jump on a plane, fly to Florida. Come back, go after it again. Make good money, big money. We're talking about coming to your house to help put the truck. Oh, no, 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 no. Shit, no. I'm building something. All we have to do is lift it out of the truck onto my little something that sits in front of the truck. We're just going to slide the hood up. Connect it, it's connected, it's on. The hood is easy. Then putting in the fucking lights and putting the mirrors on on the fucking bumper. The big star pattern fucking bolts that bolt into the bumper. Probably. Anyway, it's nothing, man. A bumper probably take about 5-10 minutes to get it off. Maybe more. Had to spray a bunch of that PB blaster on there, break those fucking bolts off. New bumper goes on, 5-10 minutes. The hood probably take maybe a half an hour tops. You know, maybe longer with the fucking headlights and shit like that. Within 3 or 4 hours, that truck can be back on the fucking road, man. No problem. No worries. No problem. 300 a flight round trip. Then who's gonna go get your ass? There you go. There's your question. Who's gonna go to the airport and pick your sorry ass up? It ain't gonna be me. I'm out here trying to make these couple of dollars right here, try to keep them from taking my fucking house. Cause somebody put me in a bad position. You heard me? Uber don't come out there. Peggy won't pick your ass up. Y'all miss the fact that she's pretty mean. Pretty hateful. Don't like people. Yeah. And Uber won't take you out there. There ain't no Uber around us. I'm in the fucking country, guys. I am in the country. I am in the sticks. Just outside of a country town. That's way the fuck outside of a town. Next to a city. I'm way out there, dude. I have no idea, man. We ain't got shit. We're lucky to have a Walmart. And we still gotta drive 20, 30 minutes to get there. My daughter is in fucking Austin, you idiot. She ain't gonna do that. I don't know if they go anywhere. I know she wouldn't do that. There's no fucking way she would do that. She ain't gonna carry somebody that damn far. Just to me? Just to me what? She is. Oh, Peggy? No, hell no. No, no, she's a mean person at heart. That's funny. That's funny shit right there. I don't care who you are. Now, Chance, I think he's biding his time right now until he gets enough experience so he can go out to the oil fields. I think he really, 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 really wants to go out there and drive. I think he does. I'm not sure, but I get that feeling. But, yeah, but I don't think he's got 1 year. I don't think he's got a year. He doesn't have a year of verifiable experience. He has more time with me than anybody. Driving tourists. How come y'all are so hard on Chance, man? Y'all cut him a little bit of slack. He'll grow up one day. He might be 50 when he does it, but he'll grow up one day. He'll get there. No, I think he just turned 25. Back in January 24th, I think. His birthday is right after mine. I wanna say he was born in 94. Yeah, I think he's born in 94. So make him 25 now. He just turned 25. Well, I can cut him some slack because I know things. And you know things. We know things. Cut him a little bit of slack because we know things. A veteran rookie. Yeah. Yeah, he's a veteran rookie. I'm gonna say something nice about him though. He never wrecked my truck or trailer. He never backed into anybody on the side like Tree Fitty did. How he did that, I have no fucking clue, other than he just cannot see. I'd be interested in talking to the safety department where Robbie works right now. Because he has a bunch of fucking accidents on his record. Propecia? Okay, now I gotta look that up. That's a $2 word, man. I gotta look that up. Don't tell me what it means. Oh, it's drugs. Oh, I thought that was a big word. What the fuck is it for? Urinary retention medication. Treats an enlarged prostate. So you don't pee-pee on yourself? That what you're saying? That bed-wet medicine? But I'm pretty sure if you talk to safety over there where Tree Fitty works, I'm pretty sure something has happened since he's been there. Something. Well, neither one of them pre-tripped or post-tripped. Hard to get them in, hard to get them out of the truck once they're in it. Oh, that's just wrong. That's just wrong. That's Rogaine. That's not Propecia. That's Rogaine. You know, it's funny you should say he looked like Elmer Fudd, because like three people saw his picture one day and they said he looks like Elmer Fudd. Swear to God, man. I know Tree Fitty didn't check them tires. I got $1,200 says he didn't fucking check them tires. Man, them boys cost me a lot of money. Tree Fitty cost me the most. He cost me about, recalculating, about $7,700 during his tenure. Retarded. At least I didn't have to put but one tire on the truck when Chance was driving. And that wasn't his fault. Oh, it was little things from the beginning. $1,200 of it, he paid back, but... Oh, fuck, man. He cost me a shitload of fucking tires. Of course, the $1,200 and some odd where he backed into a fucking truck. He ended up having that giving that back to me. Made a fucking deal for that shit. $1,300 for him not doing the paperwork correctly. They wouldn't pay us on a fucking order. Cost me $1,000 right off the bat because I felt sorry for him, and I paid him for a week of work that he hadn't even worked. I gave him $200 cash when I first met him, so you know, the kids would have some money while he was out on the road. He'd be able to, you know, his funky ass girlfriend would be able to you know, get milk and bread and shit like that. And then I paid him he went to orientation for a couple of fucking days. Nobody gets $1,000 for going to orientation 2 days. But I paid him $1,000 at the end of the week, and I bought him a fucking helmet and a vest. You know, two people can fit in that fucking vest real easy. I mean, I can't use it. I got no use for it. I don't know what the fuck to do with it. And bought him a whole cart full of fucking groceries. I mean, I poured money into that dude. Fucking hotel alone was $100 and something a night. That fucking Uber back and forth. I mean, he just skyrocketed. He took a fucking you know, he was off for a week. I paid him for the week that he was off. While when the truck first broke down, right after we got it, not his fault, definitely not his fault. I paid him for that week. He comes back, and a week or two later, you know, he takes off for one of his, it wasn't even his daughter, it was his stepdaughter's birthday. Stayed off like 4 or 5 days, expected to get paid at the end of the week, another $1,000, because he was on a minimum. And it added up over time, $1,200 for tires, just one thing after another, man. Ended up coming up to about $7,700. He went to Kansas City, pick up a load, got the paperwork, drove over in front of the trailer, and hooked up to the trailer next to it, drove it all the way to fucking Dallas. It was supposed to go to Georgia or Alabama. That's funny shit right there. I don't care who you are. See, on that paper, it you know, there's a seal on there. If you get your fat ass out of the truck and you go back and you look at the seal and you compare it to the paperwork, the seals are going to be different on the paperwork. That might be a clue that you got the wrong trailer. But just happen to just take a peek at the trailer where the fucking number is like this fucking big, and noticing that the trailer that you're supposed to have is, it's different. And he wouldn't fuel at the cheaper places after we talked about it. He would never stop at the cheaper places. He bypassed a cheaper Love's to go to the Love's that he likes further down. Cost me an extra $60. Then he started hitting the tolls. Because he didn't like driving up Oklahoma roads up 69. He liked going up 35. It's longer. He says it's faster, but it wasn't. Going up 35 and then through Wichita and shit and getting on the fucking tolls over there. Oh, man. Fucking toll bills just kept coming, man. They just kicking my ass, man. One month alone, what was it? $900 and some odd in tolls, his truck alone. It's like, we're going the same route back and forth, and there ain't no tolls. How I got a $900 and some odd toll bill? Mm-hmm. $7,700. Well, the Sirius satellite radio, that's chance. That's up to $79 overdrawn on that account right now. It goes up $6 a day, being over the limit. And I can't stop it. It's just going to keep going up until they close the account. And he did not have permission to use that fucking car. Hell, he used the car all the time and didn't have permission. Was told specifically not to use it, and he used it all the time. I don't know why he thought I wouldn't notice that he used that fucking card. I don't know why he thought he could be sneaky and do that stupid shit. I don't know why he get on here and say, I tell him I'm mad at him for that stupid shit. And he says, oh, I canceled it. I called them. No, you didn't. You didn't bother to do shit. I didn't pay for his wedding. I paid for his honeymoon. I paid for the motel for his honeymoon and for the cold drinks and the plates, the paper plates from Dollar General, I think. Yeah, they cost me a lot of money. But at least Chance, he stayed longer. I think he was here longer and cost me less. And he didn't hit shit. He didn't hit shit. If he could have woke up on time, wouldn't oversleep every fucking day, I would, man, he'd get some big high marks from me for the bullshit he pulled. Fucking, how do you oversleep? You're at the consignee. How do you oversleep? How are you 4 hours late to the consignee? You slept on their fucking parking lot. How? How are you 4 hours late? Maybe only three hours late. I digress. I don't get it. Took goddamn good care of both of them dumbasses. Neither one of them was worth what I was paying them. They did not have the experience level, and they did not have the performance. Truefitty liked to sit there and feel like he was a damn good dedicated employee and shit like that, but he was guilty of the same shit. He was guilty of other shit. Yep. I put these phones. This phone right here was in one of the trucks. I put phones in all the trucks so that the brokers wouldn't have their personal number, wouldn't bother them. You know, the phone, you know, was a backup and shit like that. But these phones, they also have fucking alarm clocks. You can have all these alarms going off everywhere. And you got internet on it, unlimited internet, Verizon. So, you know, you can watch your little shows. You can do whatever you want to. It didn't bother me. Provide them with everything I can. Set them up for success. They don't care. They do not give a shit. I'm out here doing the exact same job, making less than they did. Driving, putting on as many or more miles as them. And they ain't appreciate shit. It's all right. It's all right. Karma bus. It's a karma bus, man. And it won't slow down after it hits your ass, by the way. It'll run right over you. Keep going. You fuck around, it'll back up over you just to make sure it got you. Karma bus coming. It's just the way that it is. Use the e-log to track him down. Yeah. Funny thing, man. Call somebody, ask them where they're at. You can see them moving. You can see where they're at in real time. Somebody want to tell a lie. Nah, that's not where you're at. Busted them a couple times like that. Yeah. Yeah. You gotta do that. You gotta do that, Mike. You gotta set the fucking bar. Yeah, draw the red line in the sand, whatever the fuck you want to call it, man. When they cross it, you just, you got to come down hard like a fucking hammer. I found out, trying to be a nice guy, you let one thing go by. Oh, shit. Hang on, y'all. Hang on.
Help
me out a little bit. I'm trying to get back to Louisville, Kentucky. I have absolutely nothing. Like, you get any change, anything?
Nah, I ain't got nothing, buddy.
This is James. Mm-hmm. Rock on. So which one of them bays is it? Go in from the backside? All right, and the office, you know, faces the Loves right there, you know, and then I'm calling the one right next to it Bay 1 and the next one Bay 2. Which one you want me in there, man? All right, so the one closer to the office and come in from the opposite side, the back side. Okay, I'm on it. Thank you. All right. All right, got to go get my shit fixed, y'all. Fucker me. Let's go over there. Dun, dun, dun. Yeah, that dude just asked me for some change. Said he's going to Louisville. He ain't got nothing. I don't know where the fuck he came from, man. He just came out of nowhere. Now he's going back across the parking lot. I hate losing my number one space here. Yeah, he's not a driver. He's walking back over to the gasoline pumps. I found out the cure for that shit of having to beg was get a job. I found it out. I think it was on a meme. I think I seen a meme on Facebook or some shit. What are you doing, man? We ain't going nowhere. Dun, 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 dun. Anytime. We got three people over there stupid parking right next to the damn shop. That's craziness. Gotta go salting like 4 a.m. I believe it. Nasty shit you got going on over there. In the northeast. Where they don't give a shit in the northeast. Still the fucking tires right off your car. Lot lizard? No, he wasn't a lot lizard. That was a dude. No, he shit no. Mm-mm. He's just trying to get somewhere. Nah. I am not the bank. You don't come to me for the money. I'm not taking money out of my kid's mouth to help your sorry ass out. Nope. Ain't gonna happen. You heard me? I said you heard me. Dude, you're gonna have to move, man. What are you waiting on, man? Waiting on a student driver? Stupid driving like that. stupid parking like that. Oh, looks like mail. Maybe they're just doing a little dirty business right there. Yeah, they're all mail trucks. Oh, come on, man. Come on, man. Let me go get my damn tires. Just like Juniper, just don't have the black fenders, the charcoal gray fenders. A lot more light business going on too. Chicken lights. Anytime. Same dude that was parked in front of me, now he's backing into a spot. It's gonna take me 20-30 minutes just to get across the parking lot to get my damn tires looked at. What are you doing, Milton? Oh, come on, man. Put it in that damn hole. You know that old song, "Give me 40 acres and I'll turn this rig around"? These days I'm coming across people, 40 acres, that's just enough for them to jackknife in, man. They can't get it around, can't do it, wouldn't be prudent. Anytime. No, Milton, what the fuck? Yep, you could have already done that, dude. Gonna back in that little hole, or are you going for fuel? You dumbass, you could have already did that. We did both. Anytime. Come on, turn it loose. My hill climbing. Not hill climbing thing. My anti-roly-roly thing on the hill, man. Shit. It's the real deal, man. It's in full effect. Everybody in the club get tipsy. Coming in for a landing. I'm coming. Quit talking to them people. Look at me when you're waving me in. Interstate batteries. Ooh. It's cold out there. Why is it so cold out there? It's cold in here now. You heard me? I'm gonna let y'all see what it look like over here. Flip it. Not too bad. And that's where I was, right over there. Yep, right over there on the other side of the scale. Now I'm all up in here. Gotta get my poofer. Man, they make me get out. I don't wanna get out.
Which miles,
boss? Well, let's see. I'm in Baxter. 205-093.
Are they, do you know how they're paying? Are you paying?
Oh, hell no, I ain't paying. No, that's their trailer. The way y'all call it, y'all don't call it eShop. Y'all call it eShop.
Oh, Shop Connect.
Shop Connect, that's it. Yeah, Shop Connect. It should already be on there.
That's right, yeah. I forgot. I had a bunch of other stuff.
Yeah, I called them sons of bitches. Twice.
Yeah. Sometimes you have to.
T-1741. Woo-hoo. It's cold up in Hurro. Oh, yeah. Ah, shit. Gotta go in there and do the fax thing. Sunny beaches. Y'all got a fax out here?
Fax?
Yeah. You do?
Yeah, we got a fax machine there.
Because I need the registration on this. Can I fax something over to you?
Yeah,
rock on, baby. That rocks. I'm gonna go do that right now. How about that? I'm gonna get a shower before I leave this place. Y'all remind me. I don't wanna forget. Mm-hmm. I give you a call in just a second here, man. Let me get this fax business taken care of. I need registration on this on this trailer. Ain't got none. Had to have them send it to me. I was still gonna get it done even if I gave the trailer up, because I wasn't gonna leave that for somebody else, because that's not right. That last little bit of bubble cup juice wasn't right. Alright, people, I'm gonna go do what I do. And we'll see y'all down the road, alright? I'll call you in just a minute, Josh.